I bought a lot of books, like an excessive amount of books, and this is gonna be a collective book haul. Everyone say hi to Lily because she's going to bed. She's being too crazy. Dream a little dreamer. Welcome back. I have a pretty big book haul for you today. And this is sponsored by Barnes & Noble, and which is a small trip. And then also 30 books that I bought from independent bookstores. So let's get right into it. First, actually, this is not a purchased book. This was given to me by my boss. It is The Last Thing He Told Me by Laura Dave. And I'm really interested to see how this is. The spacing in it is very interesting to me. Like, it seems very light, but like not like the story's light. It just, I don't know, I'm excited. I feel like I'm gonna get through this really quick. And it's also on my TBR list for May, which I'm actually gonna film a TBR list or a TBR video soon. If I have energy after this, I might even do it now. Into what I bought. So I was at Barnes & Noble a few weeks ago, and I ended up, if you haven't found this out, Barnes & Noble now has a premium membership, which I already had like the normal membership, so you can just upgrade it. And they have a premium membership where you can get a discount now, and you earn like rewards points, and there's other perks too. But the discount and the rewards points were enough to make me do it. I was so excited about that, so I did that. And I kicked my membership off with buying books. I got two books by Yonomi Park. I'm having a hard time saying her name, but I'm practicing. But she is a woman that escaped North Korea. She was sold into sex slavery there, and her journey just seems amazing. And I actually watched some of her YouTube videos not too long ago. It was probably a few years ago now. So that is a little bit of a long time. I watched her videos a few years ago now, and it just seems like she has a really incredible story. So I've actually been wanting to buy this one for a long time. This is In Order to Live, A North Korean Girl's Journey to Freedom. And this is her new book. And actually she went on a podcast that my boyfriend watches recently. And so now both of us are kind of interested in her story. Anyway, I'm really excited to read this one. It's called While Time Remains. And I'm just really interested to see her perspective on things. And then I also got How to Change Your Mind by Michael Pollan. This goes into the new science of psychedelics and what it's teaching us about consciousness, dying, addiction, depression, and transcendence. I'm very interested in this. I'm so curious about this topic. Truly just so curious. So it's kind of a hefty book, so I don't know when I'm gonna get to it, but I am very interested, so. And I'm not gonna lie, a lot of these books, I really don't know that much about, but I am that kind of reader. Like, I don't love knowing that much about the books before I read them. And I feel like a part of it, that's just like a part of the fun, like a part of the mystery for me. So that's kind of how I enjoy to get my books. So if it seems like I don't know a lot about a book, it's probably because I don't. Then I bought The Phantom Tollbooth. Which I'm really excited about because I read this in elementary school and I remember really loving it. And so I just wanted, like, I've had this on my TBR list for a long time, and it was on the buy one get one 50% off book. So I just paired these together and got this one. Okay, so we're getting into the bulk of the haul. So I participated in this event called San Diego Book Crawl, which is basically, it's the same concept as a bar crawl, but there's no alcohol involved. It is just straight book buying fun, and 13 bookstores participated in it this year. It's 13 indie bookstores, and it's in celebration of Indie Bookstore Day. You get this passport, and the passport has like all of the different stores right here, and then you get stamps like as you go, and it even had like a map and everything. So I went to all 13, I got all of the prizes, and I bought a bunch of books, and I've been saving for this for like a year now, so I really allowed myself to just get whatever I want, and it was the best thing ever. I am personally an impulse shopper, and so I just allowed myself to be impulsive, and I loved it. I'm gonna go ahead and kind of break it up, not by genre, but I'm gonna go and do the graphic novels and manga that I got first, and then I will do the rest of the books. So if you are interested in graphic novels or manga, you can go ahead. I'm gonna like chop this up into cards, so you can just skip to the next part if you want. So I really allowed myself to kind of go crazy with graphic novels, because a lot of the time I feel kind of guilty buying them because I can go through them so quickly, and a lot of the time I don't end up wanting to keep them, even though like if I'll love an art style and all of this stuff, but realistically like I just don't have that much space to store books that I'm not going to read again, and so I end up selling them back to like a used bookstore or giving them to people. So I kind of try to stay away from buying graphic novels unless I'm like very into the series, but I love them. I love them a lot, and I love the idea of collecting them. I just am not in a place to where I can do that yet. But anyway, I allowed myself to buy a lot of them during this trip because I just needed to. And there's a bunch of series that I've really been wanting to read, and also just like standalone graphic novels that I've been wanting to read. So I got some. And so the first one that I got was Monstrous. This is the second, this is volume two. I read volume one and I really enjoyed it. I enjoy the art style. It is kind of gory, as a story. Gory as a story. The story is a little gory, or like the graphics are. So like, if you don't like reading that, then don't. It's not that bad, but like there were some things in the last one and I was like, oh, that's a little harsh. It's a little harsh. Like, I think I just wasn't expecting it, you know, but it was very good. So I got volume two. I'm excited to see where things go. And honestly, this series has been calling to me so much that I might end up buying like the first one and just actually collecting them, because like these thin ones like this aren't that crazy to store. I just need to find a place to store them. I got Seance Tea Party, which is so cute. Like, look at this art style. Look at it. Like, it's just too cute. I am obsessed with it, and I don't really know what this is about, except like honestly, Seance Tea Party. Look at the cover. That's really all you need to know, right? Okay, this next one I have been seeing all over Goodreads, and I was really attracted to the art style. This is The Moth Keeper, and it's actually by the author of Tea Dragon Society. So if you like that and that writing style, you might like this, but it's just so cute. And I actually haven't read Tea Dragon Society. It is on my list. I probably would have gotten it on this crawl if I had seen it, but I didn't. So I got this one. I'm excited about it. I don't know if this is going to be a series, but I think it seems like it's just a standalone. And okay, a little break from graphic novels, because this was just next to my pile. I got two mangas. I got the Spy Family books. I'm so excited to start this series, you guys. I'm so excited. I have heard so much about this, and I've been wanting to start it for a long time. And I actually bought the second one on accident, and then I had to buy the first one. So I have the first two. And I'm really excited. All I know is that it's about a family of spies, and that just sounds fun. Then we have Mooncakes, which art style, period. It's just too good. And I'm kind of excited that it's a hardcover. yeah, I don't really know anything about this. This has been on my list for a long time, strictly because of the art style. So I hope I like it. We have Taproot. This is another art style buy. It's a story about a gardener and a ghost. And it just looks really cute. And like these colors, love. Then I got Hookie, which I'm really thrilled because I've been wanting to read this for a really long time. Again, art style, witches, love. Like just love. I'm in a very like ghosty, witchy mood. You'll notice that throughout this haul. I've been reading Harry Potter for the first time. I just finished The Order of the Phoenix. And I think I just love the idea of magic. I just do. So I love the idea of witches. And yeah, the art style, again, just too pretty. Then the last one that I got is The Prince and the Dressmaker. Classic. Really cute, cute art style. I'm very excited about this. And I just want to have like, I really want to do a 24-hour readathon and read like a bunch of these, or maybe get like the rest of the Spy Family series and just read like all of them in a 24-hour reading challenge. I think I would do it though, where I like start the timer and then stop the timer when I'm not reading and do like a collective 24 hours, because I don't think I can do a straight 24-hour readathon. It just doesn't, I just can't do it. Anyways, let's get into the rest of the books. Okay, I'm gonna probably go through these a little bit faster because again, like I don't know too terribly much about each one. And these are in no particular order. So there's gonna be just a variety of things. So the first one I got is The Source of Self-Regard. It's a Toni Morrison, like eclectic book. It goes through a bunch of her different essays, speeches, meditations, all the things. I have read Toni Morrison's work specifically in my sociology theory class, and it really intrigued me. So I have been wanting to read more of her work. Then I got Like a Mother, which is a feminist journey through the science and culture of pregnancy. I am like obsessed with motherhood and pregnancy, and it's just always been something that really interests me. I'm just interested to learn more from this. Then I got The Sentence by Louise Erdrich. And this book is about a indie bookstore that is being haunted by its worst customer, which just sounds so interesting. Like I said, another ghost story. Then I got The Will to Change by Bell Hooks. I've read Bell Hooks in my sociology classes as well. So I'm not in school anymore, but I really found a lot of the reading that I did in school very interesting. So I've been wanting to get kind of back into that recently. So this will help me do that. Okay, you've probably been seeing this all over the place. This is Legends and Lattes by Travis Baldry. And the way that I've heard this described is that it is about two monsters who just run a coffee shop, and there's not much more to that. And I love that idea. Like, I love a good no fuss read. It is a standalone. It's just like a good, enjoyable, cutesy story from what I've heard. So I'm excited about that. I keep saying I'm excited, and honestly, it's just, we just gotta practice more of the dialogue on the YouTube. I got Pure Color, which is a novel by Sheila Hetty. And this seems really existential from the summary. It says, here we are, just living in the first draft of creation, which was made by some great artist who is now getting ready to tear it apart. In this first draft, a woman named Mira leaves home for school. Once there, she meets Annie, whose tremendous power opens Mira's chest like a portal to what she doesn't know. When Mira is older, her beloved father dies, and she enters the strange and dizzying dimension that true loss opens up. Pure Color tells the story of a life from beginning to end. It is a galaxy of a novel, explosive, celestially bright, huge, and streaked with beauty. It is a contemporary Bible, an atlas of feeling, and a shape-shifting epic. Sheila Hetty is a philosopher of modern experience, and she has reimagined what a book can hold. Like, yes. Then I got Wayward by Amelia Hart. Again, don't know too much about this one. I do know it is around the time frame of World War II, and that I love the cover and that it's popular right now. And those are the reasons why I bought it. Then I bought Finalists by Ray Armantrout, and I haven't seen this before. It's by a UCSD alumni, and so I bought it for that reason, because I went in the bookstore and I was like, that's really cool. And it's poetry, and it is poetry month. Or actually, no, it's not poetry month anymore. It's May. But it was poetry month when I bought it. Then I bought Divine Rivals. I have no idea what this book is about. I just love the cover. It's been everywhere. I can't run away from this book. I feel gravitated towards this book. And I needed to read it, so I bought it, and I hope that I like it, because I did not read the summary or anything, and I think that will actually be a lot of fun. And I did a blind date with a book, so this was wrapped up in brown paper, and it just had like a few clues on it. It said it was a fantasy, a minor ghost story, saving the world, you know, all the things. And I'm actually really excited. I've never seen this book. I don't know anything about this book, but when the lady was checking me out, she said that she really loves this author's writing style and like anything by this author. So I'm excited. It's also really small, so I think it'll be like a good quick read sometime. It's only 137 pages, which is interesting considering it's a fantasy. So I'm very curious about this one, and also really happy with the pick. Then I got Donna Tartt's The Secret History. This has been all over BookTok, Bookstagram, BookTube, everywhere. And honestly, I totally forgot the summary. I put it on my TB, like my want to read list on Goodreads a long time ago, and I just totally forgot about it. And then I saw it in one of the stores and I was like, I'm just gonna get it. And I don't remember what it's about, but I am excited and also loving the flop. Like, okay, a few more. So I've already shown some of the things that I've gotten from this store, but I went to this store called Meet Cute in San Diego, and I really wasn't that excited about it because it's a romance store and I'm not a romance gal. Like, I don't really love romance. However, they had a fantastic selection and I ended up buying like 4 books from there, and I want to go back. Like, I loved it there. And so if you are in San Diego, going to San Diego, you should go to Meet Cute. Okay, my phone died while I was filming, so excuse if there's like a tone change or anything. I feel like a lot of the time if my phone dies, my tone totally changes when I put the battery back into the camera, or if I charge my phone and then I come back to it, or whatever. The vibes just change, and I was like in a groove. But we're gonna get back in the groove. We're gonna get back in. Anyway, I was very excited about the Meet Cute store, and another one of the things that I got was this book. It is Juniper and Thorn. I have no idea what this is about, but the cover was cute. Oh, I just started reading this. It says, a gruesome curse, a city in upheaval, a monster with unquenchable appetites. I don't even need to read anything else. So this sounds good. Then at one of the used bookstores, I was really excited because I got 2 hardcovers that basically look new. So the first one that I got is The Last Nomad. And this is a coming of age story in the Somali desert. So I'm very interested. I haven't really read anything about this area. So I'm very interested to see what this is like. And I was like, this kind of goes along with the Yomi Park books. This is a North Korean story. So this is Without You, There Is No Us, My Time with the Sons of North Korea's Elite, a memoir by Suki Kim. And I didn't really read anything else about this. I just feel like it's going to be good. So we will see how this is as well. If there's anything that like stands out to you and you want me to like include it in a video, let me know down below. I would love to do that. There's just not a lot of conversation yet, you know? This is my debut as like a book lover. So let me know. Then I got The Vanishing Half, and this is a best-selling book that has been on my radar for a while. I don't know too much about this. I kind of just like read half of the summary, but it is about two sisters. They're twins. They're identical twins living in a small Black community in the South and running away at the age of 16. And that's all I really want to know. It seems very interesting. It's also signed by the author, Britt Bennett. So cool. Like, I just think that's so fun. And I saw that it was signed and I was like, I have to get it. So then this book just gets like A plus for flop, like A freaking plus. This is Labyrinth of the Spirits by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. Anyway, this is during the Spanish Civil War. I've read another book that was around a similar time frame, and I really just like the writing like about that time frame. That's really all that I read before I got it. But it says Alicia lost her parents at the age of 9 when the nationalists savagely bombed Barcelona. 20 years later, she carries the emotional and physical scars that from that brutal era. Weary of her work as an investigator for Spain's secret police in Madrid, she's ready to move on, but her boss's insistence, she agrees. That was so trippy. My phone just like stopped recording. Anyway, excited for that one. And we got the Priory of the Orange Tree. Okay, we all know what this is. It's all over book talk. It's been around for a long time. It's a big boy. But actually though, it's really not that big. It's only like 800 pages, which is a lot. But like, I just read The Word of the Phoenix and that was 870. And then I was looking at this and I was like, why is it so big? And it has to just be like the thickness of the pages. But like, this is a big boy. Like, I will not be traveling anywhere with this book. All I know is it's a fantasy, like a total deep dive into a world. So when I'm like really ready for like a new fantasy world, this is what I'm going to pick up. And we got, I don't know how to say this. I think it's I don't know, it's a novel. It's written by Jessica George. And I've just heard a lot about this book. It's fair to say that Maddie's life in London is far from rewarding, with a mother who spends most of her time in Ghana, yet still manages to be overbearing. Maddie is the primary caretaker of her father, who suffers from advanced stage Parkinson's. At work, her boss is a nightmare, and Maddie is tired of always being the only Black person in every meeting. When her mom returns from her latest trip to Ghana, Maddie leaps at the chance to get out of the family home and finally start living. So I read a little bit of that in the store, but a lot of people have been really excited about this book this year, and I just jumped on the bandwagon. So here we are. Then I got Night Circus. This has obviously been very popular for a very long time, and I've heard it's rightfully so. I heard that just like the world building, like very atmospheric. So I love that, and I'm excited to give this a try. And then we have Parable of the Sower, and I honestly bought this because I saw it on Ginny and Georgia, and she was reading it, and I was like, I don't know why, but I want to read that. This is by Octavia E. Butler, and it's set like in modern times. So I'm very interested to see what this is like, because I don't really think that I've read a story that really discusses like issues in the modern time. And we all know there's a lot. That wraps up all of the books. I also got some like stickers and bookmarks and prizes from the book crawl. I'm going to show them to you really quickly, and we're going to just fly through this, because I just want to document that I got all of these. So for winning the whole thing, a mug, it says SD Book Crawl, and it has all the bookstores on the back. I got like some free bookmarks and some free stickers, but then I also bought stickers and bookmarks. I visited an independent bookstore sticker. This is a little bookmark from Meet Cute. This is a bookmark I bought. Like, how cute. Reading is a hoot. Yes, it is. Stay Weird sticker with little alien spaceship. I got this one from my friend Kayla. It's a sloth reading and she loves sloths. I got this grad card for someone that I know that's graduating. So excited to send that to her. A little book sticker, little person as a book. Look at how cool this bookmark is. It's like burnt. It's, I don't know what you call it, but it's a leather like bookmark with burnt stuff into it. I really think it's cool. Then I got this pin as one of the prizes. I got this bookmark. It's like a tarot card imitation, The Gardener. And it's magnetic, which I love magnetic bookmarks. This was so cool. So my mom grew up in former Yugoslavia and I found a bookmark made out of former Yugoslavian stamps. And I just think that is so cool. Another bookmark from the library shop, bookmark from Verbatim, bookmark from The Book Catapult, bookmark from Warwick's, mark from Independent Bookstore Day. I don't know where this is from. Oh, this is the UC San Diego one. This was another bookmark they gave out. This is Canterbury Classics, so cute. I bought this one. This is an Edgar Allan Poe bookmark, and how cool. Like, I die. And they were giving out free House of the Cerulean Sea stickers. And then I bought more stickers for journaling. Professional Bookworm, San Diego Book Crawl sticker, Animal Library card, and an otter reading a book. And that wraps up my haul. I want to thank you for sitting through all of this. It is a lot. I feel slightly gluttonous, but I saved up for this day. I need to find out where I'm going to store all of these books now. I have lots to read. So I think I'm going to film my May TBR as a TikTok. So go ahead and head over there. I'll probably also include it in this video, honestly, if it's not too long. But follow me on TikTok if you don't already. I've been kind of slow at posting, but I would like to do more. I just don't really know what I want to do on there right now. I was doing a lot of makeup stuff because I love makeup, but I'm just going to kind of change gears and post whatever I want, like I am on this channel. So that is my little spiel. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I just think it's so funny saying that out loud. But anyways, follow my channel if you would like to see more book content from me or makeup content or just life things. And I will see you next time. Bye.